Welcome, I'm Bob Lund.
And I'm Chris Raffard with Fastenal Engineering.
We're here today to talk to you about screws. Screws are a bit different than bolts, even though most people, I think, throw them into the same general category. I've got a bolt here in front of me, and when I'm installing this, Chris, I'm actually trying to squish the pieces in between the nut and the bolt together with a certain amount of force to hold it in place. When I'm talking about screws, not only are they generally smaller, but they have a little different function. What's the function of a screw?
Yeah, oftentimes what we're using a screw for is just to fasten something lighter duty down, perhaps. Maybe it's a placeholder. You know, oftentimes really the goal of the screw is just to get it seated in without cracking the mating material.
Okay, so there are different ways you can break the plastic cover on your light switch by installing the screw too far, or it might pull out of a piece of sheet metal. Other than that, there's not a whole lot that goes wrong. You're right, it's just holding something in place. So the screw has some cosmetic marketing folks are interested in some cosmetic features. You might have a round head that's got nice smooth lines, or a flat head that would go into a countersunk hole, or something with a hex head that's more industrial looking. But there's also some functionality there, both in the various heads and the points. Give me some examples of that.
So from the head standpoint, we have customers that want to keep that flush look. Maybe there's material going that's going to pass over it, and they don't want a fastener head getting in the way, holding things up, right? And in those cases, we'll use something countersunk like a flathead.
Okay. How about the food industry? They've got some rules.
Yes, absolutely. So they're more so on the drive side of things. They're going to be making sure that there's nothing that's going to get, no nooks or crannies for food to get stuck into and bacteria to form. So they're going to usually use externally driven fasteners rather than internal.
Let's flip over to the other side. We've got different points and different threads. Mm-hmm. Let's start with the threads. Machine screws that may be going into a tapped hole will have more bolt-like threads.
Yep.
In this case, I've got more space threads. What's that for?
Well, this one is an interesting example because this one was clearly meant for thin gauge sheet metal because of the point as well. We know we're going to pierce that, and we also use these spaced out threads to just almost hang off of that thinner gauge sheet metal. So we're not really developing a clamp load, we're just hanging on.
Right, if we hang on too tightly or pull too tightly, we'll pull it right through the sheet metal.
Right.
There are also points that will have cutouts and lines and things that are really just features of a tap where we're cutting threads and actually removing material.
Yeah, our friends that are in the OEM game, they're looking for opportunities to cut seconds out. Time is money, right?
Yeah.
If they can cut a tapping operation out, some of these screw threads might help them do so. You alluded to those cutting points that maybe create metal chips. Those would be thread cutting screws, and they'll have a cutting flute at the tip. The other types that we see will be thread rolling screws, and they usually have a dull triangular look or trilobular tip to them.
And they just kind of bully their way through and move material to form threads, and there's no chips to get into the electronics or whatever. There's a standard out there that covers all these screws. It's ASME B18.6.3, and it's a big, long standard that talks about all of the different head styles, thread styles, point styles, and so on. We even have screws that don't even get covered there. I'm talking about more specific things for a plastic industry. How's that different?
Yeah, the plastic industry really is on its own. There's a lot of branded types of products that have their own patents. There isn't as much standard coverage, but oftentimes, again, these different thread forms for plastics, you're going to see things like wavy threads that might hold softer plastics in for good vibration resistance, or if it's a really hard plastic, you're going to see the thread forms go from that 60 degrees down to maybe 48. A little more knife-like to cut through and not crack the plastic.
One of the things that I want people to take away from this is Fastenal has a whole bunch of field-based engineers, dozens of them, and we're there to help you when you're dealing with all of these options that you have. People ask about torque in the screw world, and I guess there is torque if you're cutting or rolling threads, but it's going to be different even with the same screw if you're using it in aluminum or steel or plastic. So there's a lot of testing that'll need to be done either at the customer or testing that we can do for them. Where can people find out more about what we can do to help in this and other worlds?
Yeah, a great starting point is Fastenal.com, but more specifically, if you want to come directly to the engineering team, engineer@Fastenal.com.
Great. Thanks for watching.
Thank you.